Howdy, folks. I'm Ray Benson of Asleep at the Wheel, and I want to congratulate the Abilene Cultural Affairs Council on 30 years of great service to the Abilene community. I'd like to tell you a little bit about my story. I grew up playing in the orchestra, bass fiddle, played tuba also in the brass ensemble. I was in the choirs and the choruses, and it meant an awful lot to me as a young musician to have these experiences which taught me A, about music, B, about how to create within an ensemble or an orchestra. In my years of Asleep at the Wheel, they become very handy, the lessons that I learned as a young man in junior high and high school. The arts also gave me an outlet for the creative instincts that I've always had as a songwriter, as a playwright, as a writer, and the dramatic arts too were such an important part, where I was in plays and musicals. And all of these really gave me a great grounding that enabled me to have, so far, a 40-year career with Asleep at the Wheel. Now let's meet a family in your community that has personally benefited by your generous gifts for scholarships at APAC, the Abilene Performing Arts Company. The Uganza family is just one of the many examples of how the arts play a vital role in developing the confidence to shine.
I grew up in Nigeria, in West Africa, and I'm the first of 10 kids. When I was growing up, girls were not really allowed to go to school. It's a priority to send the boys. But because my parents were traders and they had interaction with some of the Englishmen that were working in Nigeria at that time, they were able to know the importance of sending their kids to school. When I got the call to be a teacher, I felt like I'm so thirsty and I need to drink, you know. I don't know how to express that, but it's like I have to do this. And I have to do it in spite of the fact that I have many responsibilities already. The way we came to Abilene was as a result of Hurricane Rita. While we were in Houston, the Hurricane Rita was coming and we were told to evacuate. 9 of us had to pack ourselves in that car. We had to sleep on the road because the traffic, there was no movement. All this time, I was moving with my computer because that was my school, and I kept up with my school work. And in Albany, I had to do 2 jobs because we had to start all over. So all my kids that can work went to work, and we all, you know, started to rebuild our lives. We decided that the best thing is for us to move down to Abilene, and by this time there was room for us. We found an apartment at the Abilene Housing Authority.
Ngozika came to me a few years ago inquiring about our program and what we offered, and that she had 3 daughters that needed attention and the opportunity to express themselves through the arts, through dance, through musical theater, that they were interested in singing and movement, and she wanted to find a place for them to belong and to be accepted. She had come to the right place. Through this funding that Abilene Performing Arts Company received for our scholarship funding, we were able to provide classes for Obe, Kosi, and Ozi, and it's a wonderful joy to see them blossom as young women and young artists.
Since my children's activities at APAC, I mean, my apartment has been turned into a dancing room. They dance everywhere, in the kitchen, in the living room. When we go to the grocery store, they're dancing. Instead of walking behind me, they're dancing and trying to practice their moves. They used to be very shy, don't like to talk in a crowd, but their dance and activities at the APAC had helped them to be outgoing and more friendly, and you know, they're able to share their opinion, you know, in a crowd.
It is incredibly beneficial for Abilene Performing Arts Company to receive financial funding for our scholarship program. Without this funding, we would be unable to help students come to APAC who need the financial assistance.
As a matter of fact, the scholarship funding is why my kids are in APAC, because I have 7 kids and I have a sick mom that I'm taking care of, and so I don't make enough, so it was a godsend. She's able to not only provide my kids with scholarship, she provides them with the dancing shoes they need also. And anything that I can't afford to get for my kids and I talk to her, she always finds a way to make sure that my kids are not, you know, singled out or don't look like the other kids. She provides for them.
We are just one of the many nonprofit organizations that receives funding The HeARTS for the Arts is so very beneficial to our existence and our continuing to touch the lives of so many.
Proceeds from this performance will benefit the HeARTS for the Arts grants program. HeARTS for the Arts supports arts programming for children, the underserved, and special populations. Examples of these programs include the Center for Contemporary Arts Arts Reach Program, which provides art classes for the Boys and Girls Club, APAC, the Grace Museum Student Tours, and the Young Audiences Program, which places professional artists in the schools. Thank you for joining me in supporting this important arts program.